Every newspaper, book, and magazine must first be approved by a government agency. Located on Red Square, it's the largest department store in the city. The food displays are... Real food is too scarce.
Because it's against the law to be a middleman. To buy and resell for profit is a crime.
Established Soviet control of the region, and now the Soviet Union and Eastern Europe were signing the Warsaw Pact.
Welcome to Erangel Remastered. A beautiful scenery, but hidden mysteries and untold secrets. The first time I got to play the new looking map, I was honestly excited, and so were my friends. But we started to notice something.
What is up with these eyeballs?
Dude, I feel like it means something for sure. It has to mean something. The banners with the eye symbol were everywhere, and I mean everywhere. Just about anywhere on the map, you were bound to run into one. This wasn't just random symbols. These were here for a reason. But as we started to explore more, we started to find other things that seemed odd. Who's this random guy? You guys seen this picture of this guy on top of this warehouse?
He's pretty
serious.
That's
the Russian dude, right?
What is that?
He's probably the guy who made PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds in terms of the lore. Maybe he was born in 1968. Maybe the number's there for a reason.
These numbers were here for a reason. And when we explored further, we found other numbers as well. But before we continue, I want you to remember 1968. It will play a very important part later on in the story.
Whoa, can you drive up this?
Isn't this like the Lannister's banner here?
Looks a bit English, like.
Oh, yeah.
It's like a wyvern, kind of. Flies
yeah, these dates have to mean something. There's a 1965 on the wall. These have to mean something.
Right here.
As we continued to explore, we realized this same theme repeated. But I noticed something that was strange. There were signs on the floor with X's through the eyes. Writings on the walls seemed to be written in Russian. What did this mean? What did they want us to know? The community manager for PUBG tweeted out this underground secret area. So, we all decided to go out and find it. And so we did.
Wow!
Alright.
Oh, we're here. Oh, fire gun.
You might do your decoding stuff. Oh, look at that.
I knew at this moment they weren't messing around. This stuff wasn't randomly put here. There's a real story. A story to be told. Someone just had to figure it out. And why not it be me? So I am here to tell you the true lore behind Erangel. Buckle your seatbelts and get your snacks ready, because this story gets all too interesting. Now, after my friends got off, I decided to go into the replay mode and start looking through the map thoroughly, and these are my findings. Let's start off with the secret room. There are 5 places circled on the Erangel map. Military Base, Milta Power, Kamishki, North Georgia Pole Bridge, and West Side Bridge of Military. Now there are 2 other places, Crates near South George Pole and Mansion. These aren't circled, but pictures that are also on the wall. The most common question is, why are these places circled on the map? But the right question should be, why are there circles in the first place? And the answer is a rebel group. A group that is rising against the regime. Now the clues from this room alone can tell you they claim the blue banner with the lion crest. It's obvious because you can see the signs of the red eye crossed out. So we have 2 things solved. 1, the rebel group planned an attack against the regime who holds power. 2, the rebels claim the blue banner, and the regime claims the red banner. When keeping these two things in mind, everything starts falling into place. Going to Pachinki, a lot can be told about this story, but you can find these hints just about anywhere. But this is just where I personally found them. So let's start off with the poster with the Russian words and I in the middle. I thought to myself, finding any information could be helpful. So I decided to decipher the poster. To any Russian speaker, knowing what was said on the poster was probably obvious, but to me, not so much. So I decided to use the Google Translate app. I put my phone to the poster, and to my surprise, it told me exactly what I needed to know. The top part translates,
"Attention, curfew from sunset to dawn."
The bottom translates,
"Movement of persons and vehicles is categorically prohibited."
So this regime did not allow their local citizens to leave their homes after dark, transport people, and or use vehicles. Knowing this, I decided to translate the next word. And this word was written on all sorts of walls, and even on the picture of that mysterious man. Well, come to find out, the word meant freedom. So I can only assume the rebels wrote it. From then on, every other word I translated were majority store names, nothing too revealing. Keeping that in the back of my mind, I moved on to my next question. Why is there a date 1968? And when I looked into it, oh, did it blow the lid off this entire mystery. This is a big one, so pay close attention as I go through and explain what really happened here in 1968.
Communist-dominated governments gained power in nations. Forces moved to crush the uprising. They were subject to Soviet political and military influence.
The first thing I decided to do was to search all world events in 1968. Knowing Erangel was based in Russia, I looked for the events that they were involved in. Scrolling down the long list of everything that happened in 1968, I came across this war. And who was involved in this war? Well, you guessed it. Russia. But Russia wasn't the country we know of it today. It was actually a state. A state of a bigger country called the Soviet Union. Also known as the USSR. And those exact words can be found on the Erangel map. Now, I searched everywhere, and there's only one spot on the entire map that you can find those words. And it's in this small building in the corner of Milta Power. Erangel was part of the USSR. Now, remember the poster that said attention, curfew from sunset to dawn? Well, it just happened that the Soviet Union had the same curfew.
What I heard was about the man walking along the street at night, Moscow. Soviet soldier called to him to halt. He started to run. The soldier shot him. And another man said, "Why did you do that?" "Well," he said, "curfew."
Coincidence? I think not. So back to the war. This war was called the Warsaw Pact invasion of Czechoslovakia. Now on January 5th, 1968, the people of Czechoslovakia pushed for political liberation as a communist state and made great strides to become more democratic. This was named Prague Spring. On the night of August 20th, 1968, the Soviet Union and four other countries invaded Czechoslovakia. The goal was to normalize old political state and reign strong as a communist power. The invasion was successful. So you're probably asking yourself, but what does this have to do with anything related to Erangel? Do you recall what banner the rebels used? The blue one with the crest in the middle? Well, it just happened to be the same emblem Czechoslovakia used. This emblem was represented all through Czechoslovakia from the entire years from 1960 all the way until 1990. The emblems are almost identical. But the thing is, this is only half of it. the USSR used to often broadcast this news station, filled with propaganda and lies, only to brainwash their citizens. The opening scene to this broadcasting channel, you ask, will seem quite similar to another banner we know. The same eye used on the red banner. And the last thing I found confirms the already damning evidence we already have. After the Soviet Union's invaded, there was a rebel group called the Red Square. And the form they protested in was spray painting walls and holding signs high so all can see. And what was that word? Freedom. Today, I presented my findings. Findings that I believe ring true. Do you? And honestly, I hope you enjoyed, because I had a great time making this. It was actually a blast looking through everything and trying to figure it all out in all the certain ways. But I'm also curious what you think. So comment down below what you believe is the true story of Erringel. Oh, and I have one little announcement before I go. I hired an editor, so he's going to be helping me out a lot, because if you don't know, these videos can take many, many hours, and it's just me alone doing everything. It can take up to like 50, 60 hours sometimes to do an entire video. So this is going to be a lot of help, and his name is Isaac Epic. His content is on the screen right now, and if you guys want to go subscribe to him, I definitely recommend it. He's a great, great content creator. But that's going to be it for me, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.